What if I were to give you $1 million today, but you were to die tomorrow? What if I were to give you $1 billion today, but you were to die in 6 months? Would you take it? So, why do we live like our health isn't as important as it is? What's going on, guys? It's your boy, back here with another YouTube video. Real quick, if y'all haven't already, make sure to click that subscribe button, turn on the post notification bell. Also, I'm telling you, this will be your best year if it is your best year spiritually. I'm going to say it again. This will be your best year if it is your best year spiritually. I know y'all thought I was going to say something else, but the truth is the truth. All right, guys, I hope y'all had a blessed New Year's. Now, if y'all made a New Year's resolution, keep this in mind. 65% of New Year's resolutions end by the end of January. So, if y'all made a New Year's resolution, I don't want y'all to focus on y'all's end goal. Most people, when they make New Year's resolutions, they make it and they're like, I want to be here this by the end of this year. But what I am working on, what the Lord is showing me, what I am trying to help other people understand is just focus on today. Tomorrow has its own worries. Focus on today. So, you might have a long-term goal, but y'all should write down steps. If I do this today, then it will get me. It's a baby step to getting to where I want to be. Because that's how some people do. So, like, if their New Year's resolution's like, I want to get in the gym. Well, newsflash, your first month is going to stink in the gym. The reason why everyone that goes to the gym every day loves it is because after that month, they kept going, they kept showing up. Something that I'm learning right now is the days you don't want to show up are the days you need. I don't feel like going to the gym today. It turns out that that day could have been the best gym day of your life, but you wouldn't know because you didn't show up that day. So, as this journey, I'm going to be documenting. Consistency's key. That's going to be one of the points I'll be focusing on. Also, I also want to help y'all to understand that health is wealth. Health is wealth. In the intro, I gave y'all two great examples of how your body, your health, is more important than money. In the Bible, you know, there's a scripture that says your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Well, that's true. If you put stuff in your body, garbage, then how do you expect to be the sharpest you can be as a man or a woman? If I just eat candy, guess what I'm not going to be able to do? Think on my feet. I put in garbage, I'm going to get out garbage. I was there once, guys, on this journey through this new year. I'm going to be documenting, showing y'all how, you know, health is wealth and how if you focus on your body, one of the most important things, you'll see the blessings that the Lord will give you. You'll see all the great things to come. So, starting off, I'm going to be showing y'all what I eat in a day, and then we're going to be going to the brand new gym that opened up in Texas, Absolute Recon in Las Colinas. So, I'll catch y'all with the first and most important meal of the day, breakfast. Alright guys, for the most important meal of the day, we got my staple, my bread and butter. This bad boy. Now, it's 4 eggs with 8 ounces of lean ground beef, or you can do turkey, with crushed green chili, on top. The reason why I add a little bit of spice, because I love starting the day with a little kick. You feel me? A little kick. So this is my bread and butter, my staple. And then also on top of this, we got a Premier protein shake. This is good as well. Now, together, this probably has like a smooth that's 30. We'll just say roughly 80 grams of protein to start your day off. I mean, this is perfect to cruise and to start your day off with 80 grams of protein. Now, what I will say is this isn't for everybody. So I find and recommend and you picking something that has a lot of protein at the beginning of the day so you can start your day off perfect, glorious, magnificent. So guys, I'm going to eat this up And then I'm probably going to catch you at the new gym that I'm going to go check out. I'll let y'all know after what I think about it. We're going to be hitting back in buys. And also, I do not train to get big. I just train to look good. So, keep that in mind while you're watching me. I'll catch y'all at the gym.
I solemnly swear, from this moment forward, that I will never lose again. I will never, never be defeated.
Alright guys, we made it here to Dave's Hot Chicken in Texas. Now if you don't know, in Texas, this is a historic place for chicken. It is compared slash better than Cane's. So, I got the spiciest thing they had. I had to sign a waiver for this. Look at this. Sign a waiver. And I can smell the sauce from this. I can smell the sauce from this. So, yeah, let's see how hot it really is. This is what it looked like. Is this the Reaper? It's called the Reaper. We're gonna see how hot it is with their sauce. I had to sign a waiver for this chicken. Reminder, you don't sign waivers for chicken.
Miss Mullet. Oh my god.
Yeah, you can smell it, bro. I'm telling you.
Is it hot?
I'm waiting for it to creep up on me. I don't know, guys.
How's that reaper gone?
No way.
Why is there a chicken in there?
I don't know. It's a joke. That's
insane.
Why.
I'm
gonna
shake that out. Bro, this hot got me sweating.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I'm sweating a little bit, but for a waiver, guys, it's not that bad, but I can handle my spot. It might be getting to me now, guys.
Hey.
I need a napkin, but... Yeah. Going in for that second bite probably wasn't worth it. But I'm gonna go get some more water and come back with the final review. The Reaper signed a waiver. We'll see at the end. Just got done at Dave's Chicken, and the final review, I'd give it a 7.5. The hype in Texas for Dave's Chicken is they rate it like it's a 10 out of 10 because it's started as a mom and pop and then they expanded it. But anyway, long story short, they made me sign a waiver, right? And do I think it was spicy enough for the waiver? It depends on how well you can take your spice. Personally speaking, I don't think they should have made me sign a waiver, but it depends on the person. So, yeah, 7.5 out of 10, the rating. And if you're ever in Texas, check it out. I'll catch y'all back at home, guys. But other than that, see y'all.
Got back from the gym, AR, Absolute Recon, the new opening in Las Calenas, Texas. Let me tell y'all something. I give it about an 8.5 out of 10. Now, here's the deal. Don't listen to social media. Get your own opinion. The reason why I like it so much is because I go to a small town gym and they don't have a lot of equipment. And AR be upgrading their equipment every week. I tell you what, the other AR gym, once a week they were posting about a new gym equipment that they just added. So you invest your money in a gym that you want to get a return in. So if you're paying a good amount of money and you don't see them put that money back into the gym, that just means that the owner either doesn't care about the gym or he's money hungry. So those are some things to be looking out for when you go to a gym. Now, what I will say is it's not for everybody. There is a lot of people there at the new gym. There is a lot of new people there, but it's a pretty decent sized gym. So there's that. But if you're a beginner, I probably don't recommend going to a big gym unless you're okay with there being a lot of people. Also, another thing to keep in mind. When you're trying to build your dream physique, consistency is key. If you're not seeing progress, do not worry. Keep pushing, keep grinding. Eventually it will come. It probably took me a smooth year, maybe a year and a half, to get close to where I want to be. I'm not even where I want to be. But you got to be willing to take sacrifices and put in the work. That's something that I'm learning right now on this journey. Row 2000. If you haven't already, make sure to click the subscribe button. Turn on the post notification bells, guys. But without further ado, y'all have a blessed one. Peace. Peace.